In this video, we review the new emergency response template for the Microsoft Power Platform. Emergency response provides a set of capabilities that a healthcare organization can activate to collect data for situational awareness of available beds, COVID-related patients, critical equipment such as ventilators, staffing, pending discharges, and delivers that data into a dashboard for hospital command centers. Emergency response includes a mobile app designed for data collection by frontline workers such as RNs and charge nurses, a web app for hospital IT admins, and a Power BI dashboard for healthcare decision makers. The focus of emergency response is to enable hospital professionals to make better decisions faster. It's designed to be flexible, so whether you need to configure this for a single hospital, for a system of hospitals that spans multiple regions, or multiple systems of hospitals, all of that can be readily supported by what's included in the template. Once your organization is set up, you can now enable your frontline staff to track key data points. And all that information is delivered to a decision support dashboard that can provide you a view of the entire organization, just systems within your organization, and just facilities within those organizations. When dealing with a crisis such as COVID-19, it's understood that there's an importance for organizations to be able to share data about the crisis and use that to help make informed decisions at the regional and national level. If you are using emergency response, it can be configured to automatically feed data to the regional and national level, so it can be used in an aggregate dashboard that's going to assist with reporting and resource routing across multiple providers and regions. And we also recognize that maybe not all people will use emergency response, and for those that aren't, other organizations can add their own data to a secure portal to report on metrics and needs. When responding to an emergency, you want to be able to quickly and easily enable frontline workers. With Power Apps, they can download it from the iOS App Store or the Google Play Store and get started in moments. Now, if I click on the Power Apps application, I'm already logged in as Mark McCurry using my enterprise credentials, and I can see that the emergency response app has been provisioned for me. I've actually made it a favorite. This is the first time I've used the application. I'll be prompted to provide the hospital system, the region, and the facility that I'll be working in. In this case, I'll be working in facility 2. I'm now presented with a list of 5 different applications that I can engage in. Let's take a look at each of them. In staff and equipment, for my current location, I'm in the skilled nursing facility. I can identify how many patients that I have, and then provide detail so I can identify my number of partners, the numbers of requested. I can also identify how many have been assigned and how many are currently unassigned. I also have the ability to provide detail on my current critical equipment in use. In the case of COVID-19, that's going to be my ventilators, my PAPR hoods, my PAPR belts, and my PAPR charges. Once I've gone ahead and identified these, I can go ahead and click send, and these are provided to our decision support dashboard. In supplies, I can track the current number in stock and the number used in the past 4 hours of the items that I care the most about. For example, for this duckbill with shield, I can say that I have 25 in stock and 5 used in the last hour. Why is this important? This is going to help me understand what my burn rate is and when I'm likely to run out of a particular item. Having this information can drive better, more informed decisions about how to allocate supplies across your organization. In staffing needs, additional resources for a department can be requested. First, identify your department, enter in your location. Identify, is this a clinical or non-clinical request? In this case, we'd like to get some RNs. We'd like to have them available on an upcoming shift, and we'd like to have 2. In COVID-19 stats, I can track the number of patients under investigation as well as those that have tested positive for COVID-19 for a given location. So in the nursing facility, I could say that I have 25 and 5 have tested positive. If I want to record multiple locations, that's also available. And here I could say in other long-term care, we had 5 and 1. I can then hit send, so this information is available as part of the decision support dashboard. In discharge planning, I can track barriers to discharge across 6 distinct categories: authorization, DME, guardianship, HCS, placement, and skilled nursing facility. I can also track the number of discharges in the last 24 hours and how many I expect in the next 24 hours. The emergency response template was also designed with the understanding that some organizations may need to share devices across RNs. To do this is easy. At the end of a shift, a nurse simply clicks on their icon and then hits End Shift to make the device available to someone else. This Power BI-based decision support dashboard is also included in emergency response. I was given access to this report by a system administrator, and I logged into this using my enterprise credentials. The data contained on this top-level view is the data that's most important to me. I can see the total number of COVID patients, those patients who are currently under investigation for COVID, as well as COVID positive. I can look at bed management. I can see the total available beds, the available acute care beds, and the total acute care occupancy percentage. And I can also look at information across acute care locations. For staff management, I can also see the total number of nurses requested, total number of nurses assigned, and the nurse variance. Supply by days on hand gives me insight on when I may be running out of particular items. In equipment, I can see the total number of vents I have, the number of vents in use, and I can also see the number of vents needed. In terms of discharges, I can see how many total long stay patients I have, how many are anticipated in the next 24 hours, and also look at what yesterday's predictions were versus yesterday's actuals. You can also see that there is a little information button in each of these areas. Clicking on this can show additional drill-in detail across multiple dimensions. This is the admin app for emergency response. You can see that it has four areas: locations, dashboards, staffing, and administration. Let's start with locations. This section contains a mixture of metadata as well as information provided by the mobile applications. You can define multiple hospital systems. You can have regions that those systems are attached to. Each of those systems can have facilities. Within those facilities, you can have locations, and you can also have a number of departments. You've got metadata about the supplies you want to track, which is provided down to the mobile app, and you have all the information that's coming up from the mobile app in terms of the number on hand and the burn rate per day. And then for case management, you also have the detail coming from the mobile app related to discharge info. In staffing, you can see a roll-up of all the staffing requested, as well as look at the individual labor pool requests. In administration, you'll define the individual apps that are deployed via Power Apps. You get the app feedback that's coming in, as well as the census and COVID information that's being collected. In the dashboards area, I can see that there are five different dashboards available to me. I can see the one that's immediately displayed is for bed management, but I could also look at equipment and supply, staff management, COVID patients, and discharges. This dashboard breaks down all the information that's available to me from the mobile applications. So whether your organization is a single hospital, a system of hospitals, or multiple systems of hospitals, you can have confidence that these capabilities can be delivered and configured for your organization. And for when you do need to collaborate and share information at the regional and national level with your peers and with governments, you're going to be able to do that as well.